I am Santosh Gangkar. Today I am teaching you mechanics of material. In that one, compound stresses. This is the problem. A compound bar shown in the figure consisting of three material supported a rigidly platform weighing 80 kN. Find the stresses and the load. We have to find out the stresses here. Data. We have to find out the stresses in 1, stresses in 2, and stresses in 3, and find the load also. Load P1, P2, P3 we have to find out. If the platform remains horizontal even after the loading, also find the shortening in the length of the each. Shortening is nothing but either you can go for delta 1, delta 2 or delta 3, because it is a net. The length is given for the bar 1, bar 2 and bar 3. Young's modulus, they have given it. They have given it. Now first, I will draw the free body diagram. Free body diagram. As per the figure, the P is acting downward. 80 kN into 10 raised to 3. P is nothing but 10 raised to 3. This will be P. Next, as it acts downward, 1, 2 and 3 will get ripple upward. Therefore, P1, P2 and P3. I am using this diagram in order to solve the problem. Plus sign, negative and negative. Equilibrium condition. Equilibrium condition. The above is nothing but positive. P1 plus P2 plus P3. P3 minus P is equal to 0. Further, now in place of P1, I will write sigma 1A1 plus sigma 2A2 plus sigma 3A3 is equal to P. Now what is sigma 1? Sigma 1 we don't know. Sigma 1 into A1, area is given for bar 1, 600, plus sigma 2 we don't know, A2. 800 plus sigma 3 and A3 will be 1000 is equal to P is nothing but 80. 80 into 10 raised to 3. 80 into 10 raised to 3. Write equation 1. Write equation 1. Next, deformation. Now deformation. 1, 2 and 3 are equal. But here what happens, the lengths are different. The lengths are different. In earlier case, the lengths were same. But here lengths were different. Delta L1 is equal to delta L2 is equal to delta L3. What is delta L1? P1 L1 divided by A1 E1 is equal to P2 L2 divided by A2 E2. P3 L3 divided by A3 E3 E3. Now substitute the values here. This part I will consider as a sigma. This is also a sigma. This part also sigma. That means sigma 1 L1 divided by E1 is equal to sigma 2 L2 divided by E2 sigma 3 L3 divided by E3 E3, L3 divided by E3. Further, I will substitute the values here. Sigma 1 into L1 1000 divided by Young's modulus is, for L1 is 2 into 10 raised to 5 is equal to sigma 2 L2 1500. Young's modulus is 1.2 into 10 raised to 5. L3 into length is 2000. 1 into 10 raised to 5. Young's modulus. Now sigma 1 is nothing but 5 into 10 raised to minus 3. If you calculate these two, is equal to sigma 2 into 0.0125 is equal to sigma 3 into 0.02. Now we'll convert sigma 2. Sigma 2 is equal to sigma 1 into 5 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by 0.0125, which is nothing but sigma 2 is nothing but 0.4 sigma 1. Sigma 3 in terms of sigma 1. Sigma 1 into 5 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by 0.02. Sigma 3 is nothing but 0.25 sigma 1. Now substitute this value in equation 1. Put above value in equation 1. In equation 1, you can substitute in place of sigma 2, substitute this value. In place of sigma 3, substitute this value. Then sigma 1 becomes common and you can find out the sigma 1 value. Therefore, sigma 1 into 600 plus 0.4 sigma 1, 800 plus 0.25 sigma 1, 1000 is equal to 80 into 10 raised to 3. Sigma 1 will be common. 600 plus 0.4 into 800 plus 0.25 into 1000 is equal to 80 into 10 raised to 3. If you calculate, the sigma 1 will be 68.376 Newton per mm square. Now we are going to find out sigma 2 values. We are going to find out sigma 2 value here. Now once you get the sigma 1 value, substitute here, you will get sigma 2. Sigma 2 is nothing but 0.4 into sigma 1. This is the value, sigma 0.4 into sigma 1, 68.376. You will get 27.3504 Newton per mm square. Sigma 3 value 0.25 into 68.376, 17.094 Newton per mm square. Now we have to find out these are the stresses, we got it. Now we have to find out the load P1, P2, P3. Load sigma 1 is nothing but P1 divided by A1. What is the P1? We don't know. What is sigma 1? We know. 68.376 into area. Area is nothing but 600. You will get P1 value. The P1 is 41.0256 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. P2 is equal to P2 by A2. What is sigma 2? Sigma 2 is nothing but 27.3504 into A2, 800. You will get P2. Therefore, P2 will be 21.88 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Next, sigma 3 is equal to P3 by A3. What is sigma 3? Sigma 3 is 17.094 into A3. What is A3? 1000. You will get P3. Your P3 is nothing but 17.097 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. 17.097 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. We got the loads here, P1, P2, P3, we got it. Now we have to find out the shortening in length of each bar. That is delta L because net is always equal to delta L1, delta L2, delta L3. Now we'll consider delta L1 value here, delta L1 value, which is P1 L1 divided by A1 E1. Now what is P1? 41.0256 into 10 raised to 3. L1 is 1000. 1000. A1 area will be 600. Hengst modulus 2 into 10 raised to 5. If you calculate, the answer is 0.341. Either you can go for delta 2, you will get the same answer, or delta 3, you will get the same answer. The P will going to change, length is going to change, and area is going to change, but the answer will be remains same. Here, we can't equate 1 and 2 by using the calculator. Because there are 3 unknowns, there is no option in the calculator for counting the 3 unknowns. Counting 3 unknowns here. Not possible here. 4 unknowns. 1, 2, 3, 4 unknowns. Not possible to count the 4 unknowns. Therefore, you have to go for this procedure in order to obtain the answer. I am Santosh Gadankar. Thank you very much.